today's video has been in the planning stage for a really long time. We first came up with the idea of the video nearly two and a half years ago, and for various reasons, normally because a breaking news story came in and nabbed its place, it never actually got filmed, and it never actually got produced, and it never actually got published. The video you are about to watch was filmed just before the Christmas break, and we had originally planned to publish it early in January. But between me filming and publishing it, some really nasty stuff has happened in the 3D printing world, namely that BambuLab, the people who make this 3D printer, the brand of printers that I actually wax quite lyrical about in today's video, announced that they were changing the firmware and locking everything down. And there's a whole debacle in the 3D printing world right now that means that this brand of printer are no longer really very popular. And if I didn't already own one, I wouldn't be buying one. I'm not going to go into detail here, but I'll link to some of the best videos on the subject in the down below. Suffice to say that if you do have a BambuLab printer, maybe an X1C like I have here, you can still install the X1 Plus firmware on it. Yes, it requires a little bit of hacking knowledge. Yes, it's open source. And yes, it means you can retain full control of your Bamboo X1C or any other BambuLab printers without ceding control to BambuLab and what it wants to do, which is to push a fully locked down firmware on its printers. I'll put some links in the down below, but I just wanted to add this to today's video because, well, Nikki from 5 weeks ago didn't know that any of this was going to happen, and it would be pretty weird of us to publish the video now without adding this bit. So yeah, don't buy a BambuLab printer. I'm actually quite glad they're not a sponsor of the channel.
We're going to be focusing a whole lot this year on ways that you can work on making your EV world better. We're going to be leaning heavily into advocacy, right to repair, and into building a community. And since not all governments and leaders out there seem to want to actually lead when it comes to protecting the little pale blue dot we live on, we are all going to have to roll up our sleeves and get involved. And today, I'm going to do that by discussing something that you can, with a little investment, get up and running with very little hassle that can actually help save you money, teach you a new skill, and get you making useful things for your EV at very low cost. Yeah, 2025 is the year that you, if you haven't already, might want to consider getting a 3D printer. I've been into 3D printing now for a few years, and I don't mind admitting that my very first 3D printer, a Creality Ender 3, was quite a handful. It required you to be very hands-on and know a whole lot of things about the inner workings of 3D printing. First off, you had to assemble the thing by hand, calibrate it manually, and you had to be willing and able to do programming if you needed to get it to work nicely with any aftermarket third-party mods. And the Ender 3 was, thankfully, very willing to be modded, and I ended up throwing a bunch of different hardware on it over the years. But I also never really got great quality prints, and the things I made, while cute and useful and practical and fun, never really got to a usable level where I felt comfortable using them in my EV. But today's modern 3D printers, I'm personally a fan of my BambuLab X1C, but there are plenty of other great competent machines out there, are far more hands-off than their predecessors, and they bring 3D printing within the reach of everyone. BambuLab, and no, this isn't a sponsored video though, honestly I wish it were, makes the absolutely fantastic A1 series for under $300. Its print quality is outstanding, and I love the way that it can be unboxed and up and running in under an hour. And here's the best bit. For many of these modern 3D printers, you no longer have to be a 3D printing guru to use one. They have reached the level of inkjet printers for flat printing. Most 3D printer companies today, BambuLab and Prusa are the two I'm most familiar with, have online web portals that you can use to download 3D models to print on your 3D printer at home. absolutely free. And thanks to the really amazing community vibe that exists in the 3D printing world, you often see remixes taking place. That's the official name given when someone takes a 3D model design that's already made publicly available and then tweaks or modifies it in one way or another for others to use. You might be thinking, okay, but honestly, Nikki, what's this got to do with EVs? And in response, I'm glad you asked, because I'm about to tell you, and it's all to do with parts and automakers these days who don't seem to be able to keep spare parts in stock. Modern EVs use a lot of plastics in them, from trim pieces and covers in the underhood areas to interior cabin pieces, and those parts can, and do, break or go missing. The first generation Chevrolet Bolt EV and second generation Chevrolet Volt with a V, for example, have fabric load bay covers that clip over rigid plastic clips that themselves fit into the side of the vehicle. And those little clip pieces are always going missing. Call it bad design or just a consumable item that's bound to disappear, but it takes just one of those misplaced items and you've inadvertently ripped off the load bay cover and the doohickey it relies on to stay in place. Now, you could go to a Chevy dealership and they will probably charge you an arm and a leg for a replacement one, or sell you more than you actually need. But with a 3D printer, for example, you can head online, download the 3D model from Thingiverse, one of the most common sites for downloading 3D models, and then print a replacement for yourself. Or perhaps you're an early Ford F-150 Lightning owner whose frunk emergency release button inside the frunk doesn't have a nice little neat cover over it and has popped when you've done an emergency stop. Or perhaps you've had something similar happen with a Tesla or another frunk-equipped EV with a similar emergency release button. The good news is that you can 3D print covers that go over those switches to prevent accidental triggering, covers that pop off very quickly and easily if actually needed in an emergency. And again, you can download these and print them for yourself using freely available 3D models. From charge port door inlets to rain and snow covers specifically designed for your EV's charge inlet, you can usually download and print something that does the job just fine. And did I mention that you can actually save money? On the Ford F-150 Lightning, for example, there are these little tiny trim clips that hold the plastic trim pieces in place under the front hood. But they're not very well designed or very robust, and most people I know with one of these trucks say they've lost a few. Ford will sell you replacements attached to a whole brand new trim piece. You just can't buy the individual clips, but that's okay because some wonderful person online has designed a replacement clip you can print with just a few cents or pennies of filament. And as for how far the rabbit hole goes, well, it's up to you. I know people who started printing other folks' 3D designs from the internet who then one day decided they wanted to learn for themselves and started designing in 3D printing their own designs. I am currently teaching myself 3D modeling for that very purpose. I've seen adapters that allow you to make use of cubby holes more efficiently. I've seen cargo hooks for the rear seats, and I've even seen wheel covers that allow you to make your EV's range a little better by covering up the holes in your alloy wheels. But I'll also admit it's not all happiness and ease. Sometimes you can download and print something only to discover it doesn't work as advertised, or try something that isn't quite properly finished. Most people uploading designs for free are usually doing this as a hobby, and sometimes things don't quite work as they should. But other times, like the carpet-saving footrest I've got for the Bolt EV, they're just perfect. Beyond your actual EV, once you get a 3D printer, you'll probably find yourself printing other awesome things for use in adjacent ways. I mean, I've lost count of the number of J1772 and NACS faux sockets that exist on websites that allow you to keep your EV charging cables nice and tidy. I've got one on the front of my garage, in fact. If you can imagine it, you can prototype and then print it in higher quality with most of the consumer-grade 3D printers out there. Although, I would add here that you should generally avoid the bargain basement sub-$150 equivalent 3D printers, especially ones with no name components or completely manual operation. They are built on previous generation tech that, as I alluded to at the start of the video, might have been fine a decade ago, but frankly are the equivalent of printing on paper with a 9-pin dot matrix when everyone else is using laser tech. Despite all of that, I do now believe we're at a point where 3D printing is accessible to regular folks who aren't super nerdy, and being able to print something useful for your home or your EV is a really nice thing to be able to do. I've got a bunch of drawers attached to my desk that were actually 3D printed in a weekend because I needed more storage space. And thanks to the breadth of different filaments, that's the name for the material that you use to make 3D prints, you can usually find something that works for your needs in whatever color or finish you desire. Some 3D printers won't print using all materials, though. The ones without enclosures tend to not like to print anything that requires a particularly high temperature. And I should also note that some of the materials you print with should be used in a well-ventilated environment and can be toxic. But, and this is important, you can now make 3D prints using recycled materials. Plastic is a bane of our modern existence, and I can understand people not wanting to make things out of 3D printed materials due to the carbon footprints associated with traditional plastic production. However, it's also important to note that it's possible, if you're feeling particularly handy, to recycle plastic bottles and then use them to make new things. The process is currently still quite in depth, and I don't personally do it, but I know people who do, and report great results. I should also note that PLA, one of the main plastics used in 3D printing, is plant-derived, although that does also admittedly have ethical concerns over using crops for plastics rather than food. Generally, as with anything that consumes something to make something else, it's best to plan and make sure that you're making the thing you want before actually hitting the print button. Just like battery production for EVs, though, we're now starting to see closed-loop PLA recycling processes come into force, where PLA and other filaments from discarded or failed prints can be collected, broken up, and recycled to turn them back into new filament. One day, I'm hopeful I can do something like this at home, and some enterprising sorts are already doing this with their own DIY projects, so I'll link to some videos in the down below showing the promise of that in the long term. At the end of the day, however, while 3D printing and some of the filaments used in it can be ethically or environmentally challenging for those who are looking to reduce their carbon footprint, it's also worth noting that there's an argument to be made for local additive manufacturing. Making one clip for an adapter using additive manufacturing processes, that's 3D printing for you and me, can certainly save a lot of wasted fuel associated with making and getting a part to a dealership or shipped directly to you. Finally, if you get into the 3D printing, as I clearly have, you'll soon find lots of things that you can make for your EV and your home that you would otherwise have had to either wait for or buy that didn't quite fit your specific needs. For example, if you've spent time around our F-150 Lightning, you might notice we have a little badge on the hitch that's actually a custom designed hitch cover. And if you were at Everything Electric in Vancouver, Canada earlier this year, you might have even been lucky enough to have picked one up for free. But the thing that really excites me about 3D printing and how it can play nicely with your new EV is that it can lead to new skills, like, as I'm doing, learning 3D modeling. Skills that then allow you to custom design other parts that perhaps you can't print on your 3D printer at home, but which you could have had made using one of the many commercially available fabrication services out there. Or perhaps you then get interested in a desktop CNC machine like the Carvera Air, which is something I'm just about to take ownership of. But that is for a different video. Thanks for joining me today. And if you've got thoughts, make sure you leave them in our Discord chat room, on our Patreon page, or you can reach out to us on Mastodon or Blue Sky. Thanks to the amazing list of people scrolling by on your screen right now. They are part of the massive community of fans around the world that help fund this channel through Patreon and YouTube, covering our bills, paying our team, and making sure that we can remain 100% independent. If you'd like to join them and see your name listed here, just follow the links below. We now have new Patreon tiers that support a wide range of donation amounts, ranging from $1.50 US a month, or if you'd prefer, about $15 a year. A massive welcome to our newest supporters, Carol Bulawa, Anna Atamelodian, Scott Wilson, Obi-Wan, Merrick Hurst, Smokey Lothar, Falafel Kosa, J01, Gary, Christopher, Randall Astaro, and Jimitri. To join the list and get your shout out, become a paid Patreon member for your moment of fame. And remember, you can now gift membership to someone else. If you'd like to support us with a one-off donation, you'll also find links below to make Ko-fi and Bitcoin donations, and we even have a good old-fashioned PO box you can reach us at. Address you'll also find below. And if you're in need of some swag, our TE swag store is also linked. So we can focus on making our content even better this year and reduce team burnout, we're switching our release days to Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday on our main channel. And if you like something a little more laid back at the weekend, over on Take Two, you'll find a release there on a Sunday. Transport Evolved is going through some pretty big changes this year, though, so keep your eyes and ears peeled as we have some more exciting ways you can support us and more exciting ways to interact with us coming very soon. If you want more, the mighty algorithm thinks you'll like this video, but we also think that this one is well worth a look. See you soon, and as always, keep evolving!